Hi everyone. This is Droidji, your go-to friend for Android. It's annoying when you find your Android touchscreen not working randomly when you're typing, watching videos, opening apps, calling, or updating. You touch, tap or swipe the screen but the phone doesn't respond at all. Because of the Android touchscreen not responding to touch properly, you can't even unlock your phone to access the data inside. Some of you might try to fix a screen that isn't working right on Android by pressing the power button. However, the display doesn't work at all, or it responds, but you can't tap the turn off or restart icon. Calm down. Touchscreen not working or responding sometimes could happen in any Android phone. Samsung, Huawei, Xiaomi, ZTE, Google Pixel, Onepuls, Vivo, Oppo, Sony, LG, HTC, you can name a lot. In the following, we're going to show you what causes the unresponsive Android touchscreen issue and how to fix it up to get your phone to work again. If this video helps you fix the unresponsive touchscreen, please give this video a like, tell us in the comment, and share this video on Facebook or Twitter to help others. When it comes to why your phone touchscreen is not responding to touch, you can figure out whether it's the result of a software problem or a physical damage. Here are a few software-related issues that may lead to touchscreen not working issues. Number 1. One or a few apps get crashed because they're running together. Number 2. Your device system hangs and makes everything stuck and unresponsive. Number 3. The Android SD card or SIM card you've inserted goes faulty. Number 4. You see Android touchscreen not working after an update that goes wrong midway. Number 5. Screen protector, phone case, or the dirt stuck on the device display make the touchscreen stop working normally. Besides, Android touchscreen glitch can be the result of the display sensor not being sensitive or the connectors are loose. Some of you might find your phone touchscreen not working in some areas. For example, the upper part of the screen, in the middle, or lower part of the touchscreen doesn't work smoothly. Alright. You know the causes. Next we'll show you how to fix a touchscreen that doesn't respond or work. Before moving forward, you might worry about the data in your phone with the unresponsive screen. The good news is that most Android touchscreen problem solutions here will make your device return to normal state without deleting anything that has been saved on your phone. You're only required to restore the data from backups when you use the reset method to bring it back to factory settings to remove touchscreen failure bugs. Solution 1 is to restart your Android phone. A simple reboot sometimes is powerful enough to fix most touchscreen not working problems on Android devices. It shuts down your phone, refreshes the system and then opens up the phone with all your data untouched. Here's what you need to do. Long press the power button until you see the restart icon showing up. Tap the icon and your phone will automatically turn off and the touchscreen goes black. Wait a few seconds, your Android phone will boot up with the device logo displaying on the screen. We're using Samsung, so the Samsung logo shows up on the touchscreen. Now, you can see the touchscreen return to normal state and respond to your touch. Solution 2 is to remove the battery. If your phone is equipped with a removable battery, take it out and wait for 1 minute. Then, put the battery back correctly. Your phone display should show the device brand logo. If not, you can long press the power button to turn on your phone. Try to touch or tap and see if your Android touchscreen works again. Solution 3 is to force restart your phone. You might be confused, how to switch off the phone when the screen is not working and unresponsive. You can't even tap the power off icon to shut it down. It's easy. All you need to do is to press and hold the power button and the volume down button down simultaneously. Your phone screen will turn black, and the device logo shows up. Then, release both buttons and your phone will restart automatically. This may take you around 10 seconds. Now, check if your screen works now. If this button press combination doesn't work for your device, you can Google how to force restart the brand of your phone to fix the not working touchscreen. Solution 4 is to boot up Android in safe mode. Your Android touchscreen will not work intermittently sometimes because of one or two apps you're opening crashing. To check whether an app causes touchscreen issues, try to boot your phone in safe mode. Doing this can restart your phone with apps it's only installed initially. To get into safe mode, press and hold the power button. In the power off screen, long press the power off icon until you see the message saying to enter safe mode. Tap OK and your phone will restart and boot up to the home screen in safe mode. Touch or tap your phone touchscreen and see if it can respond normally. If your phone touchscreen works in safe mode, it means that one or two apps went wrong. To find the faulty app, you can uninstall the software you've installed recently one by one until the touchscreen issue is fixed in normal status. If not, try the next touchscreen not working solution. Solution 5 is to take out a SIM card or SD card. Chances are that you've inserted a SIM card or SD card, or both of them. Sometimes they might go corrupted, making the touchscreen on your Android phone not working right or responding. To eliminate this possibility, take out your SIM card and SD card carefully. Then, force restart your Android phone. Wait your device to turn on past the logo screen and boot up to the home screen. The same, try and check if the touch screen on your Android works normally now. Solution 6 is to remove the screen protector and phone case. This is an obvious solution when you find your Android phone display not working but the phone is on. Sometimes the screen protector or phone case is not placed correctly, leading to that your phone doesn't respond normally. So, take away the screen protector and phone case. Then, use a dry and soft cloth to clean away the dirt, crumb, or anything that would prevent the display from making a response. When you make sure there is nothing on your phone screen, restart your phone and see if your phone display responds to your touch and tap now. Solution 7 is to factory reset your Android. Alright, the last thing you can do when your Android touchscreen doesn't respond is to reset your phone to factory settings. This step is gonna delete everything you saved and reinstall the system to get your phone touchscreen to work again. We must warn you that all the phone content, except the data you've saved on your Google account, will be lost, forever. This method is not recommended if there is some important data you've not backed up on the phone. But if you've already got a backup for everything on your phone, just try the steps below to make your not responding touchscreen work again. When your touchscreen is not working at all, you'll need to put your phone into recovery mode to do the factory reset. We'll take a Samsung phone as an example and show you how to do that easily. If the steps are not fitting for your device model, you can Google how to use recovery mode to factory reset your phone brand. Here's what you need to do. Turn off your phone using the power button. Use a USB cable to connect your phone to the computer. Next, put your phone into recovery mode. Press and hold both the power button and volume up button together. When you see the Samsung logo, release only the power button and keep holding the volume up button. After a few seconds, you should see the Android recovery screen. Let go of the volume up button. Now, use the volume up or volume down button to select wipe data or factory reset option and confirm with the power button. Then, use the volume button to highlight factory data reset and select it with the power button. It'll take a few seconds to erase your phone data and reset the device to factory settings. Oh, c'est done. It'll take you back to the Android recovery mode screen again. This time, use the volume button and power button to choose the reboot system now option. Your Android phone should boot up, with the touchscreen working normally now. Solution 8 is to visit the service center. If your phone touchscreen is still completely unresponsive, go and check the screen itself. Carefully check if there is any crack or fragment on the surface of your Android phone screen. Also, think back whether you have ever dropped the phone or got it water damaged. If you do, some sensors or the connectors behind the display are prone to fall off and fail to respond to any action on the screen. In such scenarios, you'd better go to the professional phone repair store or contact your device manufacturer to fix the phone screen. If you find your Android phone touchscreen not working in some places after screen replacement, go back to the store and ask the experts for help. Okay, we've shown you all you need to know about how to fix the Android touchscreen not working or responding issues and get it to work normal again. Thanks for watching and we hope you enjoy this video. Please kindly hit the like button and share it to Facebook, Twitter or TikTok to help more in need. This will be a huge support to DroidG channel to grow bigger and deliver the best content constantly. To stay updated with the latest and useful Android tricks, be sure to subscribe to the DroidG channel if you haven't already. If you still have any question about the stuck touchscreen problems, or anything else about Android, don't hesitate to drop a comment below to let us know. We'll soon reply to all your queries in 24 hours. See you guys in the next video.